you were to ask me today how to become a full-time blogger, oh my gosh, there are just so many things, so many advice that I want to give you. But I think the first and the most important advice I could give you is that the blog is not going to be about you. It can be about something that you're very passionate about. It will not be about you as a person. It will not be something where people will follow you. Probably not, because that's how we were blogging 10 years ago, or maybe 5 years ago. That's how people use YouTube today. But personal blogs, they are not so popular anymore. I mean, how many bloggers are you following? So it's not going to be about you. It's going to be about the user. It's going to be about what people type into Google. That's the best way to go about this, because you want to answer and target topics and a niche that people are actually looking for. And you're not there to build a personal brand. Not for the first year or so, at least. That also means that your blog posts are not going to be much about your personal life. Unless you're very immersed in this niche that you're going into, then of course you can include a lot of pictures of you doing it. But for the most part, you'll just be asking Google what people are looking for. And there are so many cool ways to do this. And that's the way to do it, because then you will target articles and topics for your site that people are actually looking for and stuff that they want to learn. And I have a whole playlist about how to find topics to write on. So you can check out that playlist. So now let's talk about how you should budget your time working on this blog. The first thing you should do every time you sit down to work, and this is probably my number one advice as well, is to always start out with a blog post. Always start your work day or your work night or whatever your schedule looks like by writing a blog post, because that's what's going to move the needle for you. Then you can work on the design and all these other things afterward. When you do that and you set a schedule, you want to write one article or two articles, that's totally up to you, but something you think you can stick to. You set the schedule that you want to write a couple of articles every week consistently for at least half a year. When you can do that, then you'll be working on the most important thing and you'll be training the most important skill. You'll get more content up on your site and you'll become a better writer. And understand that the first 10 or 20 or maybe 50 articles will probably suck pretty hard. They'll not be amazing. If you want to compare it to YouTube, just go and watch my first videos. They are absolutely horrible. I'm just reading from a teleprompter and it's just really hard to watch. And my first blog posts were kind of like that. So have some mercy on yourself here. And also, if you cannot meet that schedule that you set out for, that's all right. The most important thing is to really try to work on creating content for your site. That's the first thing you should do. I see so many people starting a blog and they work on it consistently. They work on it for months. And then when you look at it, there are maybe like 5 blog posts. That's just the wrong priorities, because a blog consists of blog posts. And the more articles you have, the better chances that you'll actually get some traffic to that site. Now let's talk about how to choose a niche, like really what should you write about. You need to have at least some commercial intent. If you can't think of a list of 4 or 5 products in the $50 to $200 range, you'll probably have a hard time monetizing the site for 2 reasons. We want to make money with ads on the site and also affiliate, and you've probably heard me talk a lot about that. And those ads will not do as well if there's very little what we call commercial intent. You need to make sure that you can mention products here and there that you can really fully recommend and stand behind. And also that you can just target these, or can say, questions people have around these products. Because those type of articles have what we call commercial intent, and they just do well with ads. And of course, it's easier to send people to a product on an e-commerce store and have some of these affiliate links in your articles if there are some actual products to link to, right? And also, if you want to do sponsorships, I mean, if you want to have somebody sponsor something directly on your site, that's very hard to do if they cannot really see the link between their products and your audience. So think about that before starting out, because there are a lot of niches where it's just very, very hard to think of any products that you could promote or talk about. Marie and I just bought a new house, and when something like this happens in your life, it's a great opportunity for you to find a new niche, because you're probably getting into a lot of new stuff. So, for example, we just had this new terrace here built because this house is super, super old and we are learning how to have a pool because there was a very, very old crappy pool here with this house when we bought it. So I had to figure out how to put in a new liner and how to get that whole recycling system working with the water and the pump and the air filter and everything. And this garden is a mess right now because this very, very old woman has lived here for like 50 years. So when something like this happens, or when you're getting into a new hobby, if you are just getting into biking, skating, whatever it is, think about what you're into right now and what you would like to learn something about. Because in moments like these, you will be a beginner yourself, and it's just a great opportunity for you to teach other people what you learn and also to dive a little bit deeper into such a niche and figure out what it should be about. And maybe you need to broaden it out a little bit. Maybe you shouldn't do a site about how to build a patio or how to build a front porch, whatever. Maybe it should just be about the exterior around a house. And my next tip here is to not try and be everywhere. There's a huge misconception among bloggers that you have to be on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, maybe Clubhouse, all these different platforms. And that couldn't be further from the truth. If you look at the top bloggers, the sites that get a lot of traffic, they are usually really, really good at one or two things. They are definitely good at writing articles, and that's your main priority. And then maybe they have a Pinterest presence or a YouTube account. But you will very rarely find that people do Twitter and they do Facebook and they do Twitch and they do all these different platforms. You shouldn't do that. You should go out and register your brand name or your domain name on all these platforms so nobody else will grab your Twitter handle or try to create a profile that looks like you on Facebook down the line. Just grab them and just hold on to them, but do nothing with them. Choose maybe one other platform if you know how to do it well. If you don't know how to do Facebook or how to do Pinterest, you just have to stay away from it for at least the first year. Just focus on getting content on the site. That's so much more important. Learning how to do Pinterest and YouTube and Twitter and all these things well, it's a total other skill set than building a blog. And that's for another time. Right now, we want to get you good at blogging. So just focus on writing content for that blog for the first year or two at least, because then you will have better and better content and more of it. And then there'll be more content to promote that you now know does well with Google and with the audience. My next tip is to not do this alone. Don't make it a solo ride. If you've been following my channel here, you know that Maria and I, we are based in Denmark of all places. And there's actually not a lot of people here who blog for an American or an English speaking audience. So it's been very hard to network and find like-minded people and other bloggers and people building content or sites or what we want to call what we do here. And that's actually also my main motivation for starting this YouTube channel here, because I really wanted to meet some other cool bloggers. And I've definitely been able to do that, so that's great. So if you don't want to start a YouTube channel along your side, just reach out to some folks and see if you can maybe connect to some other bloggers. This is also why I created a community around my course from day one, so people have a way to connect with each other and find other people in the local area and just really hang out and type their questions in there and get some support, because sometimes it'll be super hard. When you write articles, it just falls flat and nobody's checking them out, and maybe it's not doing what you thought it would for the first articles. You'll need some emotional support. And I'm not saying that you have to join my community, of course. There are a ton of communities and Facebook groups and whatnot for bloggers and for new bloggers and Reddit and just so many cool places to hang out. But make sure to connect with some people. My next advice for you is to write about something that you like. Choose something where you have some passion for it. You have to love what you do. I mean, if you're going to do this your full-time thing or your full-time gig, you just have to love it. There should be some passion in there. So don't just go out and try to find the most lucrative niches or whatnot. I see people do that many times, and then after a few months, they either start something else or they just stop altogether. So first of all, think about a good niche, but really try to come at it from a perspective where you have at least some passion or something that you could be interested in. Because if you're not interested in keeping fish or playing golf or whatnot, you shouldn't start a blog about it. Please just find something where you have passion, because it will totally shine through in your articles and you will want to sit down and learn more about this. because a lot of the content you're going to put on that site will be beginner-oriented content. And it's so much more fun to write about something that you actually want to get into and something where you benefit on a personal level from every piece of advice you learn from building that content on your site. And then I would also say you should follow one strategy. Don't just jump around on the web and on YouTube picking up pieces of advice here and there. Stick to a plan or a course or a strategy or follow one person and not five different persons, because they will have different strategies. They may all work, but they might not work if you just grab a little bit of this and that. If you don't know exactly what you're doing, especially here in the beginning, you need to focus on one channel or one approach to blogging until you really get it, until you see some traction. Then down the line, when you have 50,000 page views per month, or you're making some money now and you feel like you're understanding some of the basics around how to build traffic to a blog post and how to monetize that traffic, then of course you should get inspired by the whole space of bloggers. But that's not for the first year or so. I have a lot of people coming to me and it's just so apparent that I've been following this and that and then this advice, and then they took it in this direction all of a sudden. And it's just a little unclear how we can turn this blog around, because it's going in so many different directions, like strategy-wise. So of course I have a whole outline on how I build my site, but it's not important that you follow my course. You just need to follow a course or a strategy or one way of doing it until you see some success. Find somebody that you trust and that you feel like you can learn something from, and then just stick to that until you get it. Most bloggers and YouTubers you'll find who talk about how to generate a passive income online or how to build a blog like we're talking about on this channel here will have a very long history of failures before they got to where they are today. And many times it'll make it look super easy, say just do this and that and then voila, you will have a lot of dollars in your account, and that's just not how it works for most of us. I'd say that looks a little different today because there are so many good courses and strategies you can follow today. But for example, when I started out, I think 12, 13 years ago, I started out with three different e-commerce adventures. One went horribly wrong and the two others saw some decent success. But it was definitely a long road for me to get to where I am today, where most of my processes are automated, I have a large team working with me, and that's not where you start. So of course you have to be realistic about that. But I would say a course like mine or some of the other great courses out there where you follow one strategy like step by step, that will make it so much easier for you, because you will see a blueprint that works and that has been tested over time. And that's a huge difference from starting a blog today or starting a blog like 10 years ago, because there were so many other things that went into that. You would have to build links back then to get some decent traction in Google. That's how we all did it, and it was just a very, very different world. As I've been doing this for more than a decade, it's so much easier today because you don't have to learn all these technical skills. It's not this mouse and cat chase between you and Google, how they will catch you, how far you can go out on a limb with link building or other crazy SEO strategies. Today, you can really just go after the method that I teach you about, underserved topics. So you can just go after topics that haven't been written before, and Google will have no choice other than to rank you because they have no other content about that topic. So when you do that and you follow that strategy, you can slowly and steady build your site and see some very decent growth early on. And that's what I would say is the most motivating thing, is to see something happening within the first 6 to 12 months. But also you have to be realistic here, because it takes at least half a year for most of us. In some niches and some sites just take up faster, but normally you should expect 6 to 12 months before you see some real growth on your site. And there you really need some tenacity, and you need to keep at it and keep going and just keep pushing content to that site and sort of believe in the process. That's just how it is. You gotta keep pushing content to your site in the beginning. That's one of the other very important things. Don't give up just because you don't see any traction or any traffic on your site after 2, 3, 4 months, because that's how it is with most of us. I built this site in this what I call the Build With Us Challenge, where I built a site inside my course. So there's 15 hours of video in there showing you exactly how to build a site from scratch. But even for me, after I've been building so many sites online, it still takes a long time to rank in Google for a brand new domain and a brand new site. That's just how it is. And you have to prepare yourself for that mentally. And that's what you should do together with other people who can support you and help you along the way and keep your spirit high when you need to write content for a site that has no traffic yet. Subscribe to my channel for all the strategies and tips I have around blogging, and give this video a thumbs up if you liked it. I'll see you guys around.